My name's Elaine, so hope you've been enjoying them so far. This is going to be our fourth session, I believe. So if you like to start by laying what's called Shavasana or corpse pose, we'll begin that way. As usual, I like to lay on the floor, just allow the back bones to release and lengthen away. So here we are. Lots of space in the body. And again, if you feel particularly in these areas around the back that feels a bit kind of tense or there's constriction, sometimes standing feet hip width apart can help to release. You'll notice when you do that, or if you do that, the lower back changes and there's a slight arch. Arches the back a bit more than the lower back. So feel free, as I say. And yes, you know, you can use cushions for the forehead, for the head, should I say, the back of the head, although traditionally they do like to say yoga should be on a firm, flat surface. I sometimes use a cushion. So let's welcome the breath. Again, to heighten that awareness, you may want to close the eyes and rest the hands around the belly, elbows resting on the floor. So again, as we breathe, if you can, through the nostrils, in and out. Again, it may not work for you to breathe in and out of nostrils predominantly, of course, to adapt. You're nice and relaxed around the face, the shoulders. You know, the weight of the body is supported by the ground. Let's enjoy this. Enjoy the giving back. Now let's stand the feet into floor. So again, hip width stance, bring the heels as close as comfortable towards the lower back or bottom. Interlace fingers, push the palms as high as you can. Now I'll put both knees into belly and go in a small ball as you exhale. Head and knees, small ball. Relaxing around for all of the body, the shoulders, your face, the neck. If it's too much for the neck, relax the neck back onto the floor, the head back onto the floor, to relax the neck, chin towards the chest. Keep pushing through your heels. So again, of course, we work around the space we have, we work within our own bodies. So don't push it or force it, you know, we're not here to kind of copy me as such. These are explorations. So we go with what feels right for you. That means, of course, no pain. So let's stand the feet into floor. Feet are together, arms out to shoulders, palms towards the sky. Relax your shoulder blades into the floor. Again, it may be that you work around space, maybe the side of the body. So on the exhalation, both knees to the body's left. So keeping the feet low to the floor, contact to the floor. And the head may look directly towards the sky or towards the right thumb. Again, neck permitting. Inhale back to centre. Exhale. Now, right side of the legs. Remember, breath is the key here. Inhale, back to centre, please. Hugging both knees in. You could rock forwards and back or roll onto one side, maybe a few times to get momentum. So in this cross-legged, what we call Sukhasana, making sure your right leg or right foot is in front in your cross-legged or variation. Standing your right foot in You could hold on to the ankle or hold around the ball, the foot. I'm literally interlacing around the foot. Inhale, lift high as you can. Now my leg doesn't go anywhere straight. What I am doing is nice tall spine here. So lengthen as much as you can. Even if it means bending the right knee, still pushing through that right foot. Lifting a bit higher. Am I still breathing here? So let's take the right knee out. What I'm going to do now is take the right arm and cradle underneath. You've got the calf and the shin, the leg, the lower leg, now in the hook of the elbow. Just be here so that right knee falls out. If it's too much, come back to previous. Now, you could hold onto the sole of the foot, onto the ankle. Sometimes I hook onto the big toe with the first two fingers. Either way, left arm reaches high, open. We do what's called the open side. Right foot out to the right side, left hand to the left shoulder. And you're looking towards the left thumb if you can. You're reaching, expanding wide across collarbones. So be here, two more breaths. Keep kicking into the foot you're holding. Again, it could be that you're holding onto the ankle or supporting underneath. Back to centre to cross leg or your variation. Now standing your left foot, so just bring that forward. And again, we wrap around onto either the sole of the foot, you could hold onto the ankle or leg, pushing high as you can. And again, that left leg could be bent, doesn't have to be anywhere straight. Lifting higher and higher. Now from here, let that left knee kind of drop out. Cradle your left arm underneath. I'm literally just using the crook of the elbow to rest, to cradle. And you're pushing through your heel, opening back on the toes slightly, to really flex the foot. And cross. Again, you could hold onto the ankle, right arm lifts, up, then wide. Again, it could be sole of the foot, you could hook onto the big toes. Again, maybe first two fingers could hook around here. Widen the gap here, relax the shoulders, shoulders are level. Let the eyes up towards the right thumb. Back to centre, back into our cross leg. Spread the butter bones nice and wide, remind the spine something to go from. Inhale, lift. Exhale, forward bend. Relax here for a few breaths. We're not interested how far, whether it's here, here, here. Maybe you're still sitting upright, with the intention of your forward bend. Soften, relax around your eyes, your face, your shoulders, your base, your heavy base into the floor. Walk back to the body with the hands. Interlace above the head. Let the eyes connect to the fingers. As you exhale, relax back down. Now uncross the legs. Come into an all fours stance. Spread the fingers in and upwards and pressing in. Shoulder width and the wrist above, below the shoulders. Knees in line with the hips. Hip width stance. Exhale, round the back, tuck the chin towards the chest. Long arms. Inhale, neutral spine. Exhale, let go of the bow this time into what we call cow tilt. Inhale, neutral. Exhale, cat tilt. So I'm kind of breaking down the movement here. Make it a bit more. more flowing with the breath maybe. So still be aware of the breath being ahead here. Make it more fluid for the spine, and the spine loves to be moved in these places. Take your time, of course. Any pain, you stop, of course, you come back to centre. If all is well, just carry on. A few more breaths. Again, it could be that you want to do this a bit longer, so feel free to do so. If it feels right and you have more time, come back to centre. Big toes touching, knees are wide, and let the arms lengthen away into child's pose. Let go of the head. If it works better, use the hands for the cushioned forehead. So palms are down and using the tops of the hands if that works better. You continue with this breath coming in and out. Let's lengthen the arms long, dig the toes in to down face dog. And again, just be here, nice long arms. Doesn't matter how far the heels are away, then you're bending the knees. Maybe lengthen the legs. I tend to have a natural bend in my knees, even softening whilst I'm drawing the arms long. Eyes towards the belly or the navel. Let go of the head. Inner knuckles spread and deepen into the floor. Let's baby walk all the way to the front of the mat. Hanging forward bend. Let go of the head. Hands onto waist, coming halfway, inhale. Knees are tracking the ankles. Continue as you grow along the arms above the head. Into those three fingers. First finger pointing, crossing at the thumbs. Bring your inner ankles to touch. As the eyes look down, you're lifting higher. Eyes look down, lifting higher. Quiet around the shoulders. So we're not exactly locking into the arms as such, we're relaxed around the shoulders. Exhale, side bend to the left. And just looking down the side edge or the side line, the outer line of the body. So maybe towards the little toe, the left side. Inhale, lift a bit higher as the eyes look down. Again, lifting a bit higher, might you find more room. Exhale, side bend to the right. Again, maybe the eyes look down the outer seam of the right body. Inhale, back to centre. Exhale, centre heart. Now lunging your left foot back. Legs are long here. So usually a good gaze would be heel to heel or front heel to inner arch of the back foot. Your heels rooted. Legs are long. Right arm in front, left arm behind, palms up or down, your choice. Now start to look forward. So if you wanted to tilt the hips back, you reach forward as much as you can. So I'm actually reaching forward as if somebody was literally gently pulling your wrist forward. Your arm slightly forward, the gentle forward. Let's grow into triangle. Two more breaths. And it doesn't matter where that right hand ends up on the leg, but more interested in lengthening the spine. Reverse the direction. Hands onto waist. Bring your back foot to jump it forward. The right foot goes back. Again, just reaffirm your balance. Your left foot's now forward. And again, heel to heel. Another gauge actually of what we can work to. Left arm in front, right arm behind. If it's the left foot in front, it's the left arm. Wrists above the ankles. That tends to be a good gauge actually for what's called triangle. Reaching forward again. This just helps to create a bit more space as we glide open wide. Maybe your eyes up towards the front foot, maybe towards the arm, extended. For a variation, I know I didn't stay on the other side, you could wrap around the lower back if it's too much. But wide across the chest, both legs long and bright. Reverse the direction, strong, powerful legs. Take the hands over the heart centre and bring your back foot forward again. Tandasana. Feet are together, mountain pose. Eyes are closed, palms looking forward at the side of the body. Two breaths, long, spacious breaths. Just enjoy the quietness within as we inhale, sweep the arms above the head. Let's swan dive forward on the exhalation, lifting up chest, flat back. Of course, we're not here to get exactly flat back, the back's not entirely flat. Lift up the chest, bend the knees, just create a gentle table shape. Relax both knees onto floor, again into our child's pose to rest here. Whether the arms are long or using the hands as a pillow. Toes are touching, big toes, knees are wide. Enjoy three long spacious breaths here. So we're here to open up so much more space in the body. Think of it lengthening, extending rather than stretching. More space in the body. That means your breath, more space in your mind, physical body follows. From child's pose, let's please lengthen the legs nice and long. Spread the butter bones nice and wide. Inhale, lift high as you can. As you exhale, forward bend. Doesn't matter if the knees are bent here, we're not interested how far we get the hands. And just drop into the space available. Again, it could be the knees are bent largely here, but the hands are somewhere on the legs or floor. Nice tall spine. Shoulders calm and relaxed. Let's interlace the fingers, push the palms high. Exhale, touch the floor with the fingers. Crossing your legs again. Again, if this doesn't work, keep one leg extended or both legs long. Inhale, lift. High above you, palms together. Exhale, hinging forward, relaxing down here. And walk back to the body with the hands. And cross. And again, just allow room behind you for head space. Your thumbs are going to be on the lower back, around what we call the iliac crest, which is the big bone, the pelvic bone. It's kind of the bone that you tend to find at the top. Point through the toes and let the eyes look forward. This is called fish. So you could reach the toes if the neck allows. So any neck problems, please look forward. Otherwise, open the chest. Let the head tilt back. Again, your head and neck will tell you if this isn't feeling too great, you look forward. Two more breaths here in fish. And then, depending of course where the head is, just open the elbows, relax the head finely on the floor. Bring the knees into tummy. And I'll show you two variations of inversions. This is inversion one. You could support the legs longer, higher, but I will say actually, if you're pregnant or if you're expecting, or menstruating, you bring your legs onto the floor. So it's not always a good idea. It can alter the blood flow. So again, with this inversion, or you could perhaps, again, this is not for pregnant ladies. So we don't do this one if you're expecting or think you may be expecting. And then we'll let you there for a few seconds. Knees to come out, relax back down into Shavasana. And again, I'll leave it with you. The feet are stood in or relaxing down to full Shavasana. And again, like anything, if inversions don't feel right, you come straight out of them, come straight into the outside of child's pose actually, or corpse pose. Again, those two final moves really offer only, you know, if it's a contraindication, if we're expecting, if you don't do those inversions. Closing the eyes, take you deeper. Moving into fingers, into your toes. And again, if you have the time, feel free to stay here even longer. And again, maybe play music if you wish. Find a quiet place. Standing feet into floor. Put the knees into belly. Roll onto one side and coming all the way into our seated place. Eyes are closed. Take the hands over the heart center. Namaste. Shanti. Thank you again for these yoga sessions. I hope you find them very, very helpful and relaxing. Thank you.